Hello friends, welcome to Redix. This is Bharat Gupta and this is SBI Clerk Mathematics Series Part 4. In this we'll discuss a very important part, that is cross multiplication. So what is this method? We'll discuss its concept and problems which are asked in different banking examination. So this lesson is very important because there are several questions like dishonest seller. If a person purchases some object at some price and sold some object at other price. So in this lesson, we'll discuss all these type of question. And it is very important for you to watch entire lesson so that you'll be familiar with these type of questions. So first of all, what is the concept behind this cross multiplication? Let's take one example. A person purchases 3 oranges for rupees 2 and he's selling 2 oranges for rupees 3. So can you give me the answer that whether in this case that person has profit or loss? So you simply say that he's purchasing oranges for rupees 2, 3 oranges is selling 2 oranges for rupees 3. So he's getting rupees 1 extra and he is left with 1 orange. So we can say that there is a profit. But the point is, in this case, number of objects are different. If we say that a person purchases 100 oranges at, let's say, rupees 50 and sold 100 oranges at rupees 60. So in this case, object number is same. We'll simply use profit percent formula. But in this case, we have number of objects sold and purchased are different. So for these type of question, when number of object purchased or sold are different, we use cross multiplication. No need to remember any formula, because in case of formula, you might be learn some formula from tricky books that say when this is the condition, use this formula, when this is the condition, use this formula. But my point is this, for any case, use this concept, cross multiplication. Now, what is this concept? So first of all, we have 3 oranges and he purchases CP for these 3 oranges is rupees 2 and selling price for 2 oranges is rupees 3, right? Important part, you have to write quantity on left hand side and price on right hand side. This is price. And CP, article purchase on top and article sold on bottom. If you write like this, then this question would be very easy. Now after this, we'll multiply this value to this side and this value to this side. This is known as cross multiplication. Now if we multiply this 2 to this 2, it would be 4 and 3, 3 is a 9. So forget all other values, all these values. Now our question reduces to what? 4 is CP and 9 is SP. Right? Now, why we are multiplying this? See, if a person purchases 3 oranges for rupees 2 and selling 2 oranges for rupees 3, first work is to make all these quantities same. In this, he is purchasing 3, selling 2. So we will take LCM of these 2, 3, 2, which is 6. So we have to make this number 6. For that, we will multiply 2 here. So 2 will multiply this side also. And to make this 2 as 6, we will multiply 3 here and 3 also here. So this would be 6, this would be 6. And in this case, we have 4 and 9. So finally, summing all the concept, we will simply write, a person purchases 3 oranges for rupees 2. This is CP side, quantity on left side and price on right side. And then SP, he is selling 2 oranges for rupees 3. And then simply cross multiply. We have just discussed why we are multiplying this. But in case of your examination, you have to simply multiply this. It would be 4, it would be 9. And this is what our CP and this is our SP. Forget all other things. When you cross multiplied, the value on top would be our CP and value on our bottom is our SP. Now we have to calculate profit percent. It is 5 rupees profit out of 4 into 100. So this is 125% profit in this case. Got this point? Now some example on this concept. Now very important part, because this is a video solution, you can pause or play at any moment of time in any video. So what you do, once you got the concept, pause this video once you see a question and then try to solve it. Once you are done with the solution, then play the video again. Now given that selling price of 9 article is equal to cost price of 15 article, what is the loss or profit percent on whole transaction? See, in this case price is not given, but it is given that it is equal. So what we'll do, selling price of 9 article is equal to cost price of 15 article. So we have to write cost first. So cost of 15 article is equal to selling of 9 article, right? And because these value are equal, so we'll assume that, let's say it is 1. You can assume 100, 1, X, any value. To minimize our calculation, we simply assume it is as 9. So now multiply, cross multiply this to this. This would be 9, this would be 15. So entire value will be in two line, that our CP is 9 and our SP is 15. In this case, profit is 6 rupees. So we have to calculate profit percent. This is 6 profit upon 9 into 100. Or we can write this as 200 by 3 or 66 whole 2 by 3. So in this case, we have a profit of 66 whole 2 by 3. Got this point? The benefit of video course or video class is this, that you can pause, play, or you can increase the speed or you can decrease the speed at your requirement. Now next question is, if I would have purchased 11 article for rupees 10 and sold all the article at the rate of 10 for rupees 11, the profit percent. In this case, he is purchasing 11 article for rupees 10 and is selling 10 article for rupees 11, and we have to calculate profit percent. So cross multiply this to this. This would be 100, this would be 121. So profit percent would be 21 out of CP 100 into 100. So it is 21%. Isn't it easy method? Once you complete entire lesson, you will be dealing dishonest seller question very easily using this format. Now a person buys some pencil at 5 for a rupee and sell them at 3 for a rupee. His gain percent will be, now his purchasing CP side 5 pencil for rupees 1 and selling side 3 pencil for rupees 1. Now cross multiply, we have 3 and 5. This is our CP, this is our SP. So we have profit of 2 rupees out of 3 into 100. This is 200 by 3 or 66 whole 2 by 3. Answer is A option. Now solving next question. A man purchased some X at 3 for rupees 5 and sold them at 5 for rupees 12. Till now this question is very easy, but next condition is, does he gain rupees 143 in all the number of X he bought is. So the concept that we have discussed is 3X purchased at rupees 5 and sold 5 for rupees 12. So when we cross multiply, it means we are, because in this case we have given with total gain. So what we'll do, we'll multiply like this, 5, 5 is 25, 12 is 36, and we'll multiply this 5 to this also, because we have discussed that why we are multiplying this. We are multiplying this to make purchase and sell object equal. So we are multiplying 5 to this, we'll multiply 5 to this also. So this is 15. If we are purchasing 3x for rupees 5, then we'll purchase 15x for rupees 25. Same way we'll multiply 3 to this, 15x we are selling at rupees 36, because we are selling 5x for rupees 12. So 15x for rupees 36. Now the scenario is 15x we are purchasing at 25 and selling 15x for rupees 36. So in this case, what we have 15x profit. if we purchase 15 and sell 15x, we have profit of 11 rupees, right? So, and we need a profit of 143. So what we can do, we can simply apply unitary method, 11 profit, then x purchased and sold would be 15. So for 1 rupees profit, then x purchased or sale 15 by 11, then for 143, because in this question we have to calculate profit when we purchase, when we gained 143. This would be 15 upon 143 by 11. This is 15 into 1313, 195. So we should purchase 195x and sell 195x. Our answer would be C option. Got this point? Now, this is the same question as we discussed earlier. Try to solve it. Null solution. A man bought oranges at the rate of 8 for rupees 34, 8 oranges for 34, and sell 12 oranges for rupees 57. Now, we'll make them equal. Now, 8 and 12 LCM is 3. Or what we'll do, we'll simply multiply this by 12 and this by 8. So, if we multiply this by 12, 12, 4 ja 48. And 12, 3 ja 36, 408. And we'll multiply 12 in this as well. This is 96. And then when we multiply this 57 by 8, it would be 456 and it would be 96. So the question is, 96 oranges we purchase for rupees 408 and 96 oranges we sell at 456. So finally, what we have? We have 96 oranges purchase and sell with a profit of 48. So rupees 48 profit when we sell purchase 96. So rupees 48 profit, then orange purchase is 96. So when we have rupees 1 profit, then orange purchase would be 2. Then for rupees 45 profit, we need to calculate 45 profit. In this case, it would be 90. So we should purchase 90 oranges and sell 90 oranges. So we get profit of rupees 45. Got this point? Now, the next concept in this cross multiplication is dishonest shopkeeper. Dishonest shopkeeper means what? First of all, if a person purchases, let's say, an article for rupees 2, this is cost price, and if you want to sell this article at rupees, let's say, 1000, is there any dishonesty in this condition? No, because you purchase something and you want to sell something. If you purchase, let's say, an article, let's say a lemon, you purchase for rupees 2 and you want to sell this lemon for rupees 1000, it is up to you how much markup you want to get or how much profit you want to get on an article. This is depends upon you, but due to very high competition, you can't sell this lemon at rupees 1000 unless you have a monopoly item. Okay, so if you are selling an article for higher price, you are not able to sell that article. So it means price decides competition decides price. This is what concept of economics. But in this case, let's say a person selling 1 kg sugar, or let's say cost price of 1 kg sugar is rupees, let's say 40, and selling price of this sugar at 3 shop number 1, shop number 2 and shop number 3. On one shop it is 42, on one shop it is 40, and on one shop it is 38. So might be possible customer will purchase sugar from this shop because its price is low. Given that cost price of the sugar is 40, but that person is selling this as at 40. So the case may be possible that he is gaining profit from other object or he is cheating, right? So cheating means when you are selling with false weight. What does this means? Let's say a person is selling, let's say this 38 selling price person, that person who's selling sugar at 38 or 40, what he's doing, he puts 100 gram weight and pan in which he's giving sugar at this point, and he's weighing 1 kg. So he's showing that he's giving 1 kg to the customer, but actually he's giving 900 gram. So if you are showing something and giving some other thing, this is what cheating, right? So this is what cheating all about. If you are giving weight less and charging for higher weight, this is simply cheating, right? So there are three types of cheating. Now in this part we'll discuss cheating type 1. Now type 1 is this: when selling at cost price and cheats in weight. May be possible that shopkeeper sell goods at cost price, but he gave less weight. This case is known as dishonest shopkeeper type 1. Now take one example: a dishonest shopkeeper professes to sell, let's say, onion at cost price, but cheats the customer by 200 gram in 1 kg. Find his profit percent. Okay. So question says that this shopkeeper selling onions at cost price, this line is very important, and he is giving 200 gram less in 1 kg. He is charging for 1 kg, but actually he is giving 200 gram. So the process to solve question like this, no need to remember any formula. Basic point is very easy. See, let's say he purchases 1000 gram. Why we are taking 1000? Because we have to deal question with 1 kg, so we have converted into gram. So let's say he purchases 1000 gram for rupees 1. You can assume 100x, but because he is selling at cost price, we simply assume that 1000 gram at rupees 1, and he professes to sell 1000 gram for rupees 1, because he is saying that he will sell the onion at cost price. But this is what he say, right? But actual what he does, he is selling 800 gram because he is giving 200 gram less at what? Rupees 1. So finally what, we'll neglect this line and remaining we'll cross multiply this. Same process, cost price up with weight on right left hand side and price on right hand side. So if we multiply, this would be 800, this would be 1000. Now if this number is divisible by some other number, means this is 20 cancel, and we can cancel this by 2, 4, 5. So finally this is what CP of that person and this is what SP of that person. So profit percent of that person would be rupees 1 out of rupees 4 into 100. So he is gaining 25% in this case, right? So if a person selling at cost price, this is the process to solve, and all other process in case of dishonesty, this is the method, right? Now a dishonest fruit vendor sells his goods at cost price, but he uses a weight of 900 gram for a kg weight, his gain percent. So simply what we'll do, we'll start like this: 1000 gram, let's say he purchases for rupees 1, and he is selling 1000 gram at rupees 1, because it is given that a dishonest fruit vendor sells his good at cost price. So this is what he is saying, but actually he is giving 100 gram less, or he is giving 900 gram for rupees 1. So cancel this line and cross multiply it. This would be very easy. It would be 900, it would be 1000. Now cancel equal 0, 20 cancel from both sides. So his profit percent would be 1 rupees out of 9 into 100, or 11 whole 1/9%. Answer is B option. Got this point? One more question. A dishonest dealer professes to sell his goods at cost price by using a false weight and thus gains 11.19% for weighing a kilogram. He uses a weight off. Now this question is very interesting. In this we have not given how much cheating he is making, how much weight he is giving less, but in this case we have to calculate how much weight he is giving. First of all, this line is very interesting. 11.19%. As we discussed in the previous question, our profit is 11/9. So our answer would be 100 gram for a kilogram weight. But how to solve this question? So let's say he is purchasing 1000 gram for rupees 1 and he is selling 1000 minus x gram for rupees 1. We have neglected that particular line, that we have to cancel. So simply like this, cross multiply, we have 1000 minus x up and 1000. So this is what his CP and this is what his SP. So 1000 minus x and 1000. So his profit would be x out of 1000 minus x and into 100. This is what profit percent, and this is equal to 11 whole 1 by 9. So it is 100 by 9. So this 100 cancel, 9x is equal 1000 minus x. So 10x would be 1000 or x would be 100 gram. So he is cheating by the extent of 100 gram. We have to calculate for weighing a kilogram, he uses a weight of 900 gram because he is cheating by 100 gram. Got this point? So this entire method, this entire lesson based on cross multiplication. We will solve all the example using cross multiplication. No need to remember any formula. Only formula that you remember in this case is profit percent. That is profit upon CP into 100. Right? Now, dishonest shopkeeper type 2. We have discussed type 1 dishonesty. In this case, we will discuss dishonest shopkeeper type 2. Now, type 2 is what? A person selling goods at profit or loss also cheats the customer in weight. In the previous two or three examples, we have discussed when a person selling at cost price, but in type 2 he is selling with some profit as well. Now simply start with a question. A dishonest grocer sells rice at a profit of 10%. Now he is taking profit also, and also uses weights which are 20% less than the marked weight. The total gain earned by him will be. A very important part, as in last three questions, we have given with like 800 gram in 1 kg or 900 gram in 1 kg, but in this case everything given in percentage. In that previous question we use 1000 gram, but in this case we have percentage based. So what we'll do, CP side we'll assume that 100 gram he purchases for rupees 100. Why 100? Because in this case percentage profit is also given. So he is selling 100 gram at rupees 110, but the important part is this, he is cheating by 20%. Means cheating by 20% means he is giving 20% less. So in this case selling price, actual selling price is for 80 gram for 110. Now cancel this line and cross multiply remaining part. So this is 8000 and this is 11000. Now cancel equal zeros. We have profit of 3 out of 8 into 100. Got this point? 8 is your CP and 11 is your SP. So profit percent is 37.5%. Isn't it very easy method? Okay, next question. A trader marks up his goods by 80% and gives a discount of 25%. Beside, he weighs 10% less amount while selling his goods. What is his net profit of trader? Pause this video and try to solve it. So in this case, first of all, we'll calculate how much profit he is taking. He marks up his goods by 80%. So let's say CP is 100 and MRP is 180 because he's marking 80% up. And he's giving a discount of 25%, means 1/4. 1/4 of this is 45. So it is 135. So finally, he is costing of an article for that per trader is 100, he is selling it at 135. So these two data converted to this only, that his profit is 35%. So we will start our calculation. CP side and he weighed 10% less. So we will simply use 100 gram he purchases for 100 and selling price. Now we'll directly write that condition 90 gram, because no need to write that condition again and again. If you command on this concept, simply write false weight he's giving at 135. Now cross multiply, this would be 9000 and this would be 135,00. Now cancel two zeros and 9 10 times, 9 15 time. So finally he is giving 10 rupees article, which is CP 10 and SP is 15. So his profit percent would be 5/10 × 100 or 50%. Answer is A option. Got this point? Now this is very interesting question. A dishonest dealer sells goods at 6/1/4% loss on cost price, but uses 14 grams instead of 16 grams. What is his profit or loss percent? First of all, simplify this. What is our CP and what is our SP? Now 6/1/4% loss means 25/4, or we'll write like this: 6/1/4% loss means 25/4%, or we can write this as 1/16. In this, 16 is our CP and this is our loss, so SP would be 15. This method to calculate CP and SP we have discussed in our first lesson of this series. So watch first lesson of this, then you will be familiar with this concept, conversion of percentage to CP and SP. So in this case, he is purchasing 16 gram at rupees 16 and he is selling 14 gram, because he is showing 16 gram but giving 14 grams at rupees 15. Now cross multiply this. This would be 14 × 16. This would be 224. And 16 × 50 is 240. So cancel this by 4, 4, 5, 4, 6, and this is 460. Again 4, 14, 15. So his profit percent would be 1/14 × 100, or 50/7, or we can say that his profit is 7/1/7%. So answer are not given in this. This is the method. This part is very interesting. You can solve this question using several way, but this is the easiest approach to solve question like this. Okay. Now same question, but in this case weight less is also given in percentage. How to solve this? Now in this case 6/1/4 we have already discussed. This is 6/1/4 is equal 1/16. In the previous question we have discussed this part. This is loss part and SP is 15. And this 12/1/2. Now 12/1/2% means 1/8. So this is actual weight, this is less weight, and final weight which he is offering is 7. So what we'll do, we'll simply start 8 gram he is purchasing at 16 and he is giving 7 gram at rupees 15. Now cross multiply. This is 112 and this is 120. Cancel it by 4. 4 × 2 = 8, or 4 × 8 = 32, and 4 = 30, or 14 = 15. So same calculation. Now profit percent as in the last question is 7/1/7%. You can pause this video and go back to the previous question. In that case weight is 16 and 14, right? He is showing 16 gram and giving 14 gram, but in this case percentage is given. So conversion is very important. How we can convert this value like this? If he is giving 12/1/2% less, so convert this 12/1/2% into fraction 1/8, and then 8 is actual, 1 is less, so he is giving 7, showing 8, right? Now next question. A dishonest dealer sells the goods at 10% profit on cost price but uses false meter, so his overall profit is 30%. Find the centimeter that he measure in 1 meter. Okay, now in this case we have to calculate how much he is actually giving, right? So what we'll do, let's say he purchases 100 centimeter cloth at rupees 100 and he is selling 100 centimeter at rupees 110, because he is gaining 10%. Now let's say he is giving x centimeter less, so 100 minus x for rupees 110, cancel this line and cross multiply remaining values. So this is 100 into 100 minus x, and this is 1100. So cancel this. So finally his CP is 100 minus x and his SP is 110. So his profit percent, which is 30%, equivalent to 110 minus 100 minus x. So we can write this as plus x upon 100 minus x into 100. So cancel this by 0. This is 300 minus 3x is equal 100 plus 10x. So take this 10x this side. Sorry, 3x this side and 100 this side. This is 200 is equal 13x. So x would be 200 by 13. This is what he is giving less. But we have to calculate, find the centimeter that he measured in 1 meter. So he is measuring 100 minus 200 by 13 or 1100 by 13 centimeter. He is measuring this. He is showing 1 meter, but he is giving this much. Okay. Now, dishonest shopkeeper type 3. So in this case, if a person purchases both sides while purchasing and while selling, how is this possible? Let's say a sugar vendor, when purchases sugar, this is weighing machine of sugar vendor. Let's say he puts 100 gram this side. When he purchases sugar, he puts 1 kg at this side and pan in which he is getting sugar at this side. So he is giving payment for 1 kg, but actually he is getting 1.1 kg. And while selling this sugar, what he'll do? He simply puts, this is his fault, and he puts 1 kg at this pan and sugar at this pan. So finally he is showing 1 kg but giving 900 gram. So this is dishonesty type 3. In this case, there are two possibility. One case when it is given that a person selling, X person cheating while purchasing, and Y person while selling. So there are two type of concept based on this. See, we can simply use cross multiplication method, but if there is no profit or loss or cost price is mentioned, we can simply write his overall profit. That is x plus y plus xy upon 100. See, this concept is somewhat tricky and there is confusion between several teachers with this, whether use this, or let's say one example, if a person cheats 10% while purchase and 10% while sell, so his overall profit. So some teacher or some student is solve this question like first formula, overall profit. Overall profit, this is 10 plus 10 plus 10 into 10 by 100, 21%. And some solve like this, 100 gram he purchases for rupees 100 and selling price for 100 gram is 100. But he is cheating by 10% while purchasing. So he is getting 110 gram at rupees 100 and selling 10% less, means 10 gram, 90 gram at rupees 100. Cancel this line and cross multiply remaining values. So this is 9000 and this is 11000. Cancel 30. So 9 rupees article is selling at 11. So his profit percent is 2 by 9 into 100 or 200 by 9 or 22 whole 2 by 9. So there is difference between these two method. In this method we get our answer as 21. In this method we are getting our answer as 22 whole 2 by 9. See, for SSC purpose we use this formula, and if we consider bank never ask question like this. Bank will ask question like this: 10% while purchasing, 10% while cheating while selling, and also makes his selling price 20% above the cost price. So for that we use this formula. This formula is applicable for SSC only, but there is confusion between these two methods. So my advice, if you have a question like this, apply this method. no need to go through this, but bank never asks question like this. Now, one example, a grocery dealer cheats to the extent of 10% while buying as well as selling by using false weight. What is his increase in the profit? Now, percentage profit is equal 10 plus 10 plus 10 into 10 by 100 or 21%. Answer is B option. Right? It's one answer, 22 whole 2 by 9 is also possible. But we are dealing with the same part that we discussed in the previous slide. Now, a hawker uses a false balance defraud up to the extent of 20% in buying and also defraud 20% selling. What percent does he gain on his outlay by doing this fraud? So his profit percent would be 20 plus 20 plus 20 into 20 by 100 or 44%. Answer is D option. Now this question is very interesting. Instead of a meter scale, a cloth merchant uses a 120 centimeter scale while buying but uses an 80 centimeter scale while selling the same cloth. If he offers a discount of 20% on cash payment, what is his overall profit percent? Now, this is very interesting question. See, CP side, let's say 100 centimeter he is purchasing at rupees 100 and selling price he is selling at 100 centimeter at rupees 80. Because he is giving a discount of 20%. Now, cheating process. He is purchasing 120 grams. So, this line cancel. He is purchasing 120 centimeter at 100. And this line also cancel. He is selling 80 centimeter for rupees 80. So, cross multiply remaining values. We have 8000 and we have 9600. This cancel. Or this is 12 times or we can say 5 or 6. So CP is 5 and selling price is 6. So his profit percent would be 1 out of 5 into 100, 20%. Still he is gaining 20% in this case. Got this point? If he offers a discount, so we will decrease our cost price by this. So friends, in this lesson, we have discussed type 4 of profit and loss. Very important part, we need that you subscribe our channel, like this video, so that we'll motivate to make such video again and again. So what we need a favor that you subscribe us, tell your friend that these videos are very helpful for your examination, if it is helpful. Right, if it is helpful, then tell your friends to watch these video, subscribe us, because in return we just want subscription, nothing else. Right, so all the best for your examination. We'll discuss its part 5 tomorrow.